Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And welcome. Just a few quick words. If you need to use the restroom at any time, it's down this hallway and then to the left, and you'll see there are two restrooms there. And also, if we could just silence our phones or whatever else might be making noise. And I just want to say welcome, and it's wonderful to have Lindy here with us. She's so versatile. She can sing so many different styles. It's remarkable. So, without further ado, let me introduce Linda Jackson.
Oh, Oh, Thank you. but it's a woman saying, I'm a desperate wife, and is my husband going to leave me? And you know, in those days, if you didn't have a husband, you pretty much starved to death. So it was not like, I'll just get a divorce. No, it wasn't like that in those days. Another thing I want to let you know about the Baroque period that turns off my competitive spirit is that both of these last two songs you heard me sing were originally intended for men who had been castrated as children. They are castrated, they call them castrati, and if a child shows a talent for singing, and if the parent and family is poor, they were castrated just before their voices would get lower, just before puberty. So there were other repercussions, not repercussions, there were other things that happened to these men besides their voices staying high. Their arms grew extra long. Their torsos grew extra long. They had big jaws. And so the torsos being extra long, their lungs were bigger. They could hold more breath. And they could hold the notes longer than women. So I am always determined to hold my breath, to hold a note as long as a castrati. That's why they try. But they're not, and I have to sneak in a couple of breaths. But then that's your appreciation lesson for the moment. The next piece is the Gretchenans Fundrada, and all I can say about this lead, it's considered a lead because it's a German art song. It's written by Schubert, and it is based on the Faust, And the Gretchen is the German name for Margaret, and Faust seduces her and then dumps her, and she goes mad. And that's what this art song portrays.
Oh,
You know, I'm not really a competitive person, but I am. So, Agilita, the next piece is from the abduction, from the Seraglio. And it's about this lovely lady who gets kidnapped. And where is the Seraglio? In Yemen or someplace like that?
Yeah,
is it Africa?
No, no.
Yeah, okay, but it's a desert. Anyway, it's lovely, 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 written by Mozart. But this particular aria is considered in the classical vocal opera vocal world to be the Mount Everest of the soprano repertoire. It's considered the hardest. I don't think it's harder than that first one you just heard me sing. However, I love to sing coloratura, and I have this program loaded up with too much coloratura. I have to give some up, but I would not give this one up. She's telling her captor how much she loved her boyfriend back home. Oh, I loved him.
Thank you. I live at the beach, I'm used to it, I'm kidding.
All right. Now, oh no, not yet. I had a lot of drama this past 2 weeks, so one of my pieces I'm going to need to send some notes to Kimmy. I hope you don't mind. But not this one. Chien Nui. Now, as some of you may know, I got my music degrees as my middle age. Going to school with young people that are the same age as my youngest child. And when you study voice, you have to. You envision singing all the operas, but you sing all the art songs instead. And so I didn't like art songs that much. I like Schubert. But this one art song redeemed every art song in the world because it is so beautiful. Written by Alfred Bachelet. The title is Cher Nui, and it's basically, well, Timothy and I kind of have slightly different views of it, but basically the same, but it's a young person. It sounds very filling in this piece, would you say? So it's a young person anticipating a love experience. Okay. And the night is going to be a gorgeous night. And so the singer of this song is welcoming the night with its beauty and beckoning the night to bring all of its beauty and serenity and glory and to set the scene for love.
Thank you.
Another thing that Sherry Kinney redeems is 20th century music. Because 20th century music is that's how it's awesome. And Alfred Bachelet died in 1944, so this is actually a 20th century piece. So, il est doux, il est bon is, how do you say that author's name?
Erudiad,
and it is the story of Salome that is written by Massenet. Massenet liked Salome a lot better than Strauss did. And so he represents her a lot more sympathetic. And when you think about it, when you think of the lot of women in various societies, you know, there's usually a pretty good reason for that behavior. Okay. All right. Can we just start? I do.
All right, I would like to introduce one of my classmates that I mentioned to you, composer Stephen Homestead. As a parent myself of adult children at the time, coming of age children, my our dog, this is my husband, John, right now. I noticed the behaviors of young people, the millennials. And I'll just give you a little trivia. The students that were my friends and didn't care about my age were the Korean students. They were my friends, we were pals, we had heart to heart, so forth. But also, the best friend that I acquired during this time was this young man here, Stephen Homestead. He graduated in 2005, and we're still friends. So, your mama did good. Stephen, would you like to say anything about this, please?
When I was too young to know better, I sent this piece to music. The words are from a speech by Sojourner Truth. And I was in a political science class and he read Howard Zinn's book. And I was so struck by the power of the words that I set it to music about 16 years ago. And for my senior recital at UCLA, Linda was the perfect person to sing it. And she has owned it since then.
It is on SoundCloud, a recording of that. So, ain't I a woman? By the way, I gave Steve permission to write music about any ethnic group or nationality or heritage he wants. He doesn't have to. This is just wonderful. You're going to love this.
That
It's from Sunset Boulevard. As if we never said goodbye. Let me go see.
Thank you.
Aichi?
Is it okay if he has a... Yeah, oh my God, I forgot about the gut.
Oh, you're singing beautifully.
Oh, thank you. I'll just let you know that before I went to study music and met Stephen and so forth, I was a pop singer. I sang R&B pop, and I was a session singer. You've heard, I'm sure you probably heard some of my stuff. If you listen to rock and roll radio and you watch television during the 80s, you probably heard my work. So these last two songs were sort of, in a way, homage to my old life as a pop singer. Not so old, but you know. All right. Steve and I just finished a run of singing, doing La Traviata with our opera company, Los Angeles Metropolitan Opera. And as our encore, we'd like to sing a duet from La Traviata. Parigi Caro, where Violetta is dying, but Alfredo manages to come see her in time. And she, for a minute, she believes she's going to be saved because he came.
Oh,
appreciate it. Carla back there with Portland Basket. We have a reception directly next door for you to enjoy refreshments and to meet and greet the artists. So thank you again for attending, and it's my pleasure.
Where is this people offering to meet them?
It's right in the back. There's a lady back here with her hand raised. She has the basket. So we appreciate your help very much.
We could not do this as effectively without your love of the music. So thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Refreshments are served.